not sure. About 5 years, 3 months, and 16 days, but who's counting?
You're kidding! We haven't been back here since our first date? Wow, geez, time flies.
Well, you having the best 5 years, 3 months, and 16 days of your life with us?
I love you.
Love you more.
Can I offer you guys another drink?
No, I think we'll just take a check. Thanks.
You're right back.
Thank you.
Rachel, I've got something I really need to tell you. These past 5 years of
I think you mean 5 years, 3 months.
I'm being serious. I've thought about this a lot, and every way I've thought about it, I come to the same decision. You make my life better. You bring me love and security and joy, and I can't thank you enough for that.
You did the same for me.
I'm glad that you say that. This between us, this is real. It's a good thing. I think it's forever.
Oh my God.
Will you make this forever thing, Rachel Thorne? Will you marry me?
Yes.
Can you say that just a little louder?
Yes! Yes! Oh, John!
Thank you so much, baby.
Oh. This ring. It's so pretty.
Thank you.
This ring. It's stunning. Where? To how?
It's saving.
This is a lifetime of saving.
Two lifetimes, actually.
No, you didn't.
I told you I was saving that money for a life-changing moment. This is it.
John, I don't know what to say. I know your parents would be so proud of you.
I hope so.
It really is a beautiful ring.
Glad to hear you say that. Besides, you're going to be a successful doctor in 3 years, and I won't even pay for anything anyway, so I felt like a solid investment.
Oh.
Congratulations to you both. The couple to your left has actually paid for your meal. Have a great rest of your night.
Thank you. That's so generous of you.
Thank you. Our pleasure. Congratulations.
You really are a wonderful looking couple.
That's definitely the second best thing to happen to us tonight. Shall we go then, my beautiful fiancé?
I will never get tired of hearing that.
Up until you want to start getting called wife.
Touché. Oh God, I can't wait to call my parents.
People accept it.
Of course, because I've had over 5 years to get used to your terrible dad jokes.
Oh, so we're taking it there, huh?
Don't move, give me the ring. You heard me, give me the ring, now.
Who the fuck do you think that?
Thank you.
No, no, no.
I'll be back in the morning to get the rest of my things.
Please, I'm begging you. Don't leave me! Drunk driving accident. I did buy this ring with my mom's life insurance policy, though.
What do you mean? You just lied?
Yeah, I lied. My dad was a drug addict. Meth. One night, my mom just came home and started throwing random shit into a cardboard box. She told me to get whatever I could carry, get in the car as fast as I could. I was in the kitchen filling up my water bottle when he came in. Angry. Like fucking furious. High off his ass. Kicked the door in. And then my mom started yelling at him. And telling him it was true. She was fucking his co-worker at the factory. She was gonna take me and move in with him, that she'd had enough. She was coming to get me when he took out a .44 Magnum and blew a hole in her stomach. The bullet left her spine and entered the wall about a foot above my head. And then he put the gun in my temple. Burned a hole in my forehead. And he knelt down and hugged me. That motherfucker hugged me! He said, "Don't leave me." So when I saw that gun, I remember how hot it felt. I know I'm late. I just need more time. I have nowhere else to go. Yeah, okay, I'll be up at the end of the week.
And now to honor our valedictorian for her academic accomplishments in the field of childhood trauma and psychological development, Rachel Thorne!
Thank you.
Jane, and we're the group facilitators.
It's nice to meet you, Jane.
I'm such an admirer of your work. I actually just finished reviewing the study.
Oh, really? What did you think?
I couldn't put it down. I mean, the way that you address childhood trauma is simply unparalleled. And my team and I have actually been utilizing some of the cognitive processing techniques that you talked about, and our inpatients are proving to be quite receptive.
That's amazing to hear. It's so great to see the center up and running again.
Wow, it is, isn't it? I mean, we could not have done this without your generous contribution.
Please, it's such life-changing work you all are doing here. Speaking of which, is Ted in? I was going to see if I can finalize some of the grant paperwork.
Yeah, he's actually in doing group right now, but that should be done in a few minutes, so... Actually, feel free to pop in. Some of the testimony is really inspiring, and it's an open meeting, so I'm sure you'll mind.
Sure, I'd love to see the center at work.
Yeah. It's nice to meet you.
Thank you.
It's like an escape, you know? It's the one thing that can actually shut up the thoughts in my head.
How long did this escape, as you described it, usually last?
Never long enough, I'll tell you that.
And what do you do when the high ends, when the intrusive thoughts return?
I don't know, man.
That's okay. Anyone else?
I go and look for Scruffy. Try to take him out on a walk or to the park or something.
Yeah, I guess sometimes going on a walk outside helps. Park's nice. Noisy.
Good. Jonathan, how about you?
I just shoot up here. It's the only thing that makes it go away.
Makes what go away? Jonathan, we're here to support you. We can't do that if you don't open up for us.
I don't know how I got here. I didn't drink in high school. I hated the smell of weed and cigarettes in college. I met her at a Dare Club. You know, the woman tells kids not to do drugs.
Yeah. Who's her?
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, but definitely it does, or it wouldn't have come up.
I said it doesn't matter. She left me.
I'm assuming that used to belong to her?
Yo, that's a legit stone. Why haven't you sold it yet?
That thing looks like it costs a fortune. You know how much dope you could buy for that?
Because he's not ready to let go of it yet. We're almost out of time for today, but I want you to take this next week to think about what could be preventing you from moving on. Past mistakes, past relationships, anything at all. Sound good? All right, thank you. And remember, the center is always open to you.
You could stay back for a little bit, maybe. I like the quiet.
Of course. Thank you for opening up to us today, Jonathan. I'll see you next week.
Started looking for answers. deserve that.
Get through this, John.